video, we are going to be looking at the tooth for GV Black's class 4 situation. This is usually seen when there is a fracture of the incisal edge and in cases where the carious lesion are located at the proximal faces on the anterior teeth affecting the incisal angle. We will be showing the preparation of class 4 mesial cavity on 1-1. Prior to the start of the preparation, a putty index is made. Now the important point here is to make the putty index flush with the incisal edge and not rolling over the incisal edge, following which shade selection is done by button technique. A3 is the shade selected in this case.
Here the point to be noted is that in this case, we have used a single shade. However, in majority of cases, 2 to 3 shades need to be mixed in order to obtain a desirable match.
After the shade selection, we will be moving on to the tooth preparation. Difficulty faced here is that we often give too less a bevel on the enamel, thereby compromising the retention of the restoration. So in this case, a functional bevel of 45 degrees 0.5 mm is given on the lingual surface. This bevel is too sharp for the facial aspect and create a visible junction at the composite tooth interface, hence it is not recommended on the facial aspect. A wide long bevel is given on the facial aspect using a diamond shaped burr.
So the clinical tip here that we should remember is that if the enamel is very translucent, then to create a long and a deep bevel, and if the enamel is more opaque, then the bevel should be short and less pronounced.
Etching of the tooth surfaces was done, followed by rinsing and drying. Universal bonding agent was applied, followed by curing using LED curing unit. The palatal shelf is created using the putty index, followed by placing the index and adapting the composite and placing a sectional matrix to build the proximal wall. Followed by placement of flowable composite first and then packable composite for better adaptation. This layer should be thin, not exceeding 0.5 mm. Placing the first dentinal layer. Now in this, the tip of the dentine layer should not cover whole of the bevel and should cover only a part of it. Followed by second dentine layer placement, curing of the layer. Plumber's tape was used to isolate and visually enhance the tooth, and as it drapes and helps in proper shaping of the composite to the proximal aspect of the adjacent tooth. Gross finishing was done with Shofu diamond finishing kit and final polishing was done by Soflex polishing kit.